Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.4, Problem 4. This is Section 7.4, it's problem number 4. It says, intelligence quotient, or IQ, is a measure of intelligence. IQ scores are normally distributed with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. According to Mensa, a genius is someone with an IQ score of 140 or above. So what is the probability of being a genius? So the fact that this says normally distributed means we get to use the bell curve and the standard normal chart that goes with it. So that's how we're going to answer the question. So the average is 100, so that's what's going to go in the middle. 140 is genius, and it's 140 or above is what makes somebody a genius. So we can't look up a 140 IQ in the standard normal chart. What we have to do is find the z-score for 140 IQ, then look that up in the chart. So let's do that. The z-score formula is z equals x minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So for this particular problem, z equals x, the number we want to find the z-score for is 140, minus the mean, and it tells us right there the mean is 100, over the standard deviation. So see, our standard deviation is 15. And now if you do the math, 140 minus 100 is 40, 15 on the bottom. Now, you can reduce that by 5. 5 goes into the top and bottom evenly. But I really want to get a decimal and see what I need to look up in the chart. So with the calculator, you just do 40 divided by 15 equals. And the calculator will tell you it's 2.666666. The sixes will go right to the end of the calculator screen. The last digit will be a 7. So that's the z-score, and it's positive. Again, you have to pay close attention to positive and negative. 140 minus 100 gives you a positive 40. So there's a positive 2.66666. So to look this up in the chart, it's a four-step process. Step one, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So this has like an infinite number of places after the decimal. If you go out two places, you're at the second six, and the next digit to the right is another 6, which is big enough to bump this up to a 2.67. So step one, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal and gives us a 2.67. Step two, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the 7 is going to come off. I have 2.6 and off to the side 7. Step three, write a .0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of 7, it'll be written as .07. And now step four, go to the standard normal chart. The digits from the left, the 2.6, positive 2.6, will tell you what row of the chart to go into. So I'm going to go into the 2.6 row of the chart, and I want to intersect that with the .07 column, and you will find that they intersect at 0.9962. Now again, that's not the answer, and think about it, there's not a 99% probability of being a genius. That wouldn't make sense. Everybody would be a genius, which you know is not the case. That 9962 that you get from the chart goes to the left of the value that you look up. But a genius is someone with a 140 or above. We want the shaded region on the right of the 140. So to get that, we have to do 1 minus the chart value. And when you do that subtraction, you'll get 0.0038. So it's less than a 1% probability that someone would be a genius, which makes sense. It's unlikely. It's about a third of a percent even.